Here's a look at what happened this quarter in space communications.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And liftoff at dawn. The dawn of Orion and a new era of American space exploration.
The Network's Integration Management Office coordinated space network support for the EFT-1 launch on December 5th. EFT-1 was the first flight test of Orion, NASA's next-generation vehicle for human spaceflight. NEMO began working Orion's communication services years ago, and on the day of the flight test, was able to adjust other customer schedules to free up 5 teacher spacecraft to provide near-continuous S-band communication support both to the Orion vehicle and Delta rocket for the 4.5-hour mission. For Orion, the space network was faced with 2 major technical challenges, namely EFT-1's use of a new communications coding scheme and the unique design of the communication system onboard the Orion module. For handling the new coding method, the SM was able to leverage existing ground communications hardware at White Sands, minimizing risk, cost, and schedule. Additionally, Orion used a set of phased array antennas that rotated with the module, causing the communications link to repeatedly go in and out during the mission. For both challenges, the SN's EFT-1 unique ground configuration performed extremely well, making major contributions to the EFT-1 mission success. The Orion flight director said, "Thank you, thank you, thank you for going above and beyond. We could not have done it without you. You enabled Orion to be successful on its first test flight and for America and the world to follow the journey as it unfolded. Job well done."
We have splashdown. Splashdown confirmed at 10:29 a.m. Central Time. Orion is back on Earth. America has driven a golden spike as it crosses a bridge into the future.
NASA's Laser Communication Relay Demonstration Project has made significant progress as several engineering and flight hardware components have been received and are currently undergoing testing. LCRD has received both the Flight Optical Module Solar Window Assemblies and the Optical Module Optical Assembly is currently undergoing testing in the new Optical Module Lab. Additionally, the Controller Electronics Engineering Development Unit, or CEEDU for short, was received and is in its first phases of testing. Another key milestone was the commissioning of the new ground and flight modem development lab, where the testing of the ground modem continues. The Near-Earth Network has finished testing and is preparing to support the SMAP spacecraft with the McMurdo TDRS relay system, also known as METERS. METERS provides high-speed data return services from McMurdo Ground Station through TDRS that will allow the Near-Earth Network to meet SMAP's data latency requirement. To accomplish this, McMurdo Ground Station will send data to the TDRS relay system that will link with the new third-generation TDRS 11 to relay data back to White Sands. This effort represents one of the first steps towards an integrated network and the first time the Near-Earth Network and Space Network are integrating their services. This quarter, the TDRS-M satellite went through thermal vacuum testing at the Boeing Company in El Segundo, California. Thermal vacuum testing simulates the on-orbit space environment by maintaining a continuous vacuum while cooling and heating the chamber. The thermal vacuum testing was completed prior to the December holiday, allowing TDRS-M to move forward to the next series of spacecraft testing. The Space Network Ground Segment Sustainment Development effort continues to make notable progress. 2 key demonstrations were performed in late 2014, showing the capability of the SGSS system to manage and control actual hardware, perform TDRS tracking, telemetry, and command services, and process selected simulated customer services from RF to baseband. SGSS system integration continues, with 2 of the 5 planned development increments complete. Low-rate modem testing has been completed, and high-rate modem development is significantly complete. Significant progress has been made in all the areas during the last several months. Although challenges continue to present themselves, the SGSS team continues to work proactively to solve issues and mitigate risk. And that's what happened this quarter in SpaceCom. Thanks for joining us. See you next quarter.